I am not a priest. I am not a, I am no one. But I say the truth as it is. All right? Now, this is why we say, Jesus, he said, not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will. So how somebody claim to be Christian, he is doing his will by saying Islam is peace. Isn't it Islam who killed the Christians? Isn't it Islam who occupied the land of the Christians? Isn't it Islam who forced jizya on the Christians, die or pay? What the purpose of Islam? Why Muhammad, he claimed to be a prophet? If you read the Quran, you will find Muhammad, he want few things from you. Money, power. That's it. And there is many who claim to be Christians, they want that from you. There is something in the Quran, and the Quran is copying the Bible, but yet the Quran is speaking about the apostle of Jesus, if you remember. In chapter 36, it says that take or follow those who ask you no wages. And this is speaking about the three messengers of Christ, and one of them is Paul. And here you find the Muslim city Muslims, they keep attacking Paul, but they do not know that even their city scholars, they mention Paul to be messenger of Allah. Now actually, you just remind me of something I don't want to forget. Give me a second. A silly Muslima, she posted something in the comment section today. Let me grab it. And I will show you how silly the Muslims are. They are the same as the atheists. They have the same infection. This Muslima, her name is Basma or Basrama. I don't know what it is. She said, I am losing your video, CP. I'm beginning to like it. By the way, you are the one who teach your fellow Christians that Paul, the hijacker of Jesus' teaching, one of the messenger of Allah. That's very strange. If Paul was one of the messenger of Allah, then Abu Bakr, Osman, and Ali, or all Christians, you know, all they are bastards. They are not Christians. And you question your scholars and your Quran about considering Paul the messenger of Allah, not me. And I will tell you why Allah, he decided, and why Muhammad, he decided to join Paul to the chain of the good names in the Quran. You see, the Quran mentioned the name of Mary. Is that because Islam teach that Mary, she was a Muslim? You will say yes, right? But all of us, we don't know. But he needed the name of Mary. He didn't need the name of Jesus. He needed the name of Moses. He needed the name of all the good names to make himself look legitimate. And this is why I find it very silly, stupid of Muslims to say that Paul was the hijacker of Jesus' teaching, because how come your prophet, he did not know that, and he never mentioned him. In the top of that, he make verses in the Quran speaking about the three messengers. One of them is Paul, and he is the most powerful to be the messenger of Jesus the Christ. So the question you ask yourself, how silly you are to say Paul is the hijacker of Jesus' teaching when you're a prophet, he don't agree with you because he's silly and you are smart. And when you say to me, oh, so if Paul was the messenger of Allah, then Abu Bakr and Uthman and Ali was Christian. You see how stupid you are? How you can compare somebody who is a messenger to someone he is supposedly, according to Muslim, is just a companion? He is not a messenger of God, unless you consider Abu Bakr and Uthman and Ali messenger of God. That because you are a silly person who don't use their mind when you speak. In the top of that, if we ask the Muslims, why Allah Prophet Muhammad, he did not mention Paul in any negative statement before? How come Zach and Nike, he knew more than the Prophet? Why the Prophet of Allah, after all thousands of hadith speaking about diarrhea, shaking your ass, I mean, he have time to talk about boogers, to talk about how to clean your ass with three rocks. He have time to tell you about how you can wear your wife clothes to receive verses from Allah. He have time to tell us about how and how shaitan is sleeping your nose, pissing your ears, play with your penis, go inside your anus. All this time he have to tell us a story which is funny and stupid, but he have no time to tell us that Paul is the one who hijacked Christianity. And then if we go and search the reference of Islam, we find that all Islamic scholars, they agree that Paul was a messenger of Allah. So you Muslims have a problem. You are copy-paste the same as the atheist. An atheist copy an atheist, and a Muslim copy a Muslim. And we, a Christian, we don't copy. We study and we read. And this was an order of our Lord. He said, read the books. Not like you in the Quran, where it says, ask no questions in chapter 5, verse 101. Now, the verses in front of us here, it says it clearly that there's a three messengers was sent. And those three messengers are Paul and John and Peter. Now, the Muslim, they will say to you, where in the Quran it says that? Well, hold on. Your interpretation says that, not the Christian interpretation. It's your interpretation saying that. And look what the Quran says here. And I find this is very important. Where Muhammad, he started from the Bible. It says, follow those who do not ask you any wages. Who is the one who says that? Paul. Follow those who ask you no wages. So how you follow Muhammad? Muhammad, he asked women to give their vagina as a gift. Muhammad, he asked for the fifth of every attack from the booty. Muhammad, he asked the Muslims before they meet him, they have to pay. Especially if you want to meet with him in the private. So this is a verse fit perfectly with the messengers of Jesus who ask for no wages. And this is why we should follow them. And this is why the verse says, follow those who they ask you for no wages. And you can go right now, check yourself, chapter 36, verse number 21, 22, 23, is talking about who? You will see that the Muslim scholars in every way, in every mean, agree that those are the messengers of Jesus the Christ, and one of them, his name in Arabic is Paulos, and that's mean Paul in English. And the second one was Peter and John. So the Muslims always, they attack Paul because they are ignorant, not because they are really knows what is written in their book. The funny about Muslims is they are the last one to know. It's the same as Muhammad when they told him that your wife is a cheating around. Muhammad is the last one to know because Jibreel is going blind. He will not tell him. Now, if there is any brave Muslim, he would like to say to me, I am lying about Paul is mentioned in the Quran interpretation, I challenge you. And here, by the way, we have a question. How Jesus can make somebody messenger of God if he is a messenger himself? Imagine I am just, you know, a messenger, and then I make you a messenger. Can a messenger make somebody else a messenger of God? No, he cannot. A messenger of God have to be sent by God, not by Jesus, unless Jesus is God. So the chapter here proved to us that Jesus must be God. Otherwise, how those are three messengers? Became the messengers of Jesus. As somebody said in the text now, it says messenger of messenger of messenger. That would be funny. So if Paul and Peter and John are messengers of Allah, according to the Muslims. And again, I say that Muslims are adding those names because Muslims are the same as a priest. When I'm talking about Islam or Muhammad, Muhammad or his religion of Islam is the same as lost its honor. And she is trying to earn honor. So she tried to say, this guy, he is my cousin, and this guy is my cousin, and this guy belonged to me, you know. So they search for all the good names. What we need, like Mary, let us bring Mary. Oh, Isa, bring Isa. Musa. Okay. Paul, come on, Paul. John, let us add John. Oh, Peter, let us add Peter. Why? Because Muhammad, he have no honor, and he is trying to make honor of himself by adding those names to his cult. Did you ask yourself why the Christian don't say Muhammad was a prophet and he was a messenger of Jesus? Because that will be horrible. That will be an insult to Jesus. But Muhammad is speaking about Jesus and Paul and Peter. That will be honorable to someone like Muhammad, not vice versa. Now, if we go in the Quran, chapter 36, verse number 14, and you can open any Islamic interpretation, you will see with me, it says the following, that those are the messenger of Jesus the Christ. And that additional proof that Islam is a very confused cult. Muhammad cannot keep his mind set. I mean, how you say that Jesus is a prophet, and then you come to us with a statement saying that those are the messengers of Jesus. How a messenger can make somebody a messenger? In the same time, you see how silly the Muslims when they keep attacking, insulting Paul, when their scholars agree that Paul was a messenger of God, and he was one of the greatest, actually. One of the greatest. Let us go here and read together. The story of the people of the town when the messengers come to them, and the report of the transmitted from Ibn Abbas, blah 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 blah. The city is Antioch. Guys, the city of Antioch. This is a very clear copy-paste from the Bible about Christianity, that the Bible speak about messengers who went to Antioch. Is that correct, people? Did Jesus go to Antioch? No. So who is the one who went there? The messengers of Jesus. As simple as that. So the Quran claimed that the messenger of Jesus are messengers of Allah, and yet they are Paul and Peter and John. And here they are giving them names as titles: Sadiq, Saduq, Shalom. I mean, which mean the truth, the truthful, and the peace. And then narrated that the city was Antioch. And they read the say, we sent to them two messengers, they denied them both, mean they hastened to believe in them. Fa'azzazna bi-thalith. So we string them, or we reinforced them with a third, mean we supported them and we string them with the third messenger. Ibn Juraij narrated from Wahab, from Ibn Sulaiman, from. The name of the two messengers were Shamoon, which means Simon Peter, and Johanna, which means John, Johanna. And the name of the third was Bulos. Do you see it, Abdul Potato? Hey, Abdul Potato, do you see it? What is the name of the third? So it is not me who teach my followers that Islam teach. It is your teaching, you idiot. I'm just getting you busted. Bulos have nothing to do with Islam, and your prophet is nothing but a thief. He steal name to give himself an honor. So when we show you what's written in your book, not because we believe in it, we are spanking you, and there's a huge difference. So when you call Paul names, you are insulting your religion, insulting your God, insulting your prophet, accusing him to be a liar, and we agree. We agree that your prophet is a liar. And here, your prophet, he made himself look like a fool, because how Jesus is a messenger, yet he is sending messengers. And remember, those are not messengers to deliver a message. They are messengers of God. This is what the Quran says. The Quran says, we sent to them two messengers. They denied them. And then we reinforce them with the third. Who is saying we? Supposedly Allah. But all of us, we knew that those are the messengers of Jesus the Christ. So shut up, and you've been spanked and served. And don't ever dare to play with the Christian prince. You are no match, and you are no one. If there is any Abdul in the bushes, so we don't show those verses and show those texts because we believe in it. All of this is garbage. We don't believe in it. We don't believe in Muhammad. Even your prophet, you do not even know how to quote the name correctly. If you read the name in Arabic, you will see how funny the Muslims are. They don't even know how to quote the name Yohanna correctly. They don't know even how to quote the name Shamaun correctly. This is why Muhammad, he said, Miriam is the daughter of Umran. Who is Umran? There's nothing is called Umran. Who is Umran? Moses is the son of Umran. Who is Umran? It is Umram. So Muhammad, he thought that Mary, she is the sister of Aaron, the sister of Moses, and both of them, they have a father. His name is Umran. Why? Because the city Muhammad, he'd been taught by the Jews that Aaron and Moses, they have a sister, her name is Maryam. So he thought this is the same Maryam, she is the mother of Jesus. So now, according to the city Muhammad, Moses is the uncle of Jesus. Hey, Moses, I am Jesus. Uncle, how are you? I see there is a Muslim here, he's upset. Right. That's a good sign. Prove me wrong. Your prophet could not quote a one name correctly. Not even one name. In the Quran, when he called him Abraham, when he called him Ibrahim. Ibrahim in the Quran, his father, his name is Azar. Azar in Aramaic means foolish or stupid in the old Aramaic. So now the Muslim, they think that the name of Abraham's father is foolish. Why? Because the Quran says that Abraham, he said to his father, Azar. And they could not translate the word, so they said this is his name. But the fact this is a word Muhammad is stealing from people who they are around him. And they said to him, Azar, did not translate, which is a word mean foolish. Foolish, are you going to worship an idol? That's what he was saying to him. This is why in this cult everything is mixed up. The Holy Spirit is Jibreel. How in the world he is an angel and he is a Holy Spirit? Even the city Quran says that the spirits are not angels. They are two different creation. Is that right? Any Abdul disagree? If I am a Muslim, the Muslims, they agree regardless if I am saying something stupid or not. They agree. Here we go. This is your city Quran saying the day when the spirit and the angels are ranked together. If the angels are the spirit, it's going to be silly to say the angels and the spirit. Do you see it? So how Jibreel is a Holy Spirit? If I say the cats and the dogs, that means dogs are not cats and cats are not dogs. Otherwise, when I say and, that's silly if they are the same. And always we use Islamic reference, which is approved by them, believed in by them, written by them, printed by them, translated by them. How amazing. I'm very thankful for you Muslims. Imagine, look at this. Those stories collected by them, printed by them, put in books by them, translated by them, and give it to us so we can love. How grateful we are. If this is alone is not enough to prove to you that the prophet is a true prophet, you must be crazy. Anyway, I'm not going to stay longer with you. You guys, download this video too because it's not going to stay long. As you know, I don't keep my videos for long. So please share it, download it, and teach your friend about the truth. and the truth will set you free. And don't listen to anyone to learn your belief. Don't learn from your belief from somebody, at least he is not a believer. And secondly, even if somebody is a believer, you have to examine him first to see if he is really a true believer. And you better read by yourself. The Bible is there, and God, he gave you amazing way to know him. He said, knock at the door and I will open for you. Come to me. He said, my sheep, they knew me and I know them. So my friend, you do not need me to teach you about your Lord. Talk to him, read his words, and he will talk to you, and he will come to you, and he will show you the truth, and the truth will set you free. The truth is not in the hand of a man. It is in the hand of the Lord, which is given to you already. Read the books, he said, and you will find the truth. And he said, I am the truth. Anything else is false. I am the Alpha, I am the Omega. The Bible says everything was created by him and for him. And yet they say to us, where it says that Jesus is God. By him, my friend, by him we are free. And this is why you see Jesus, he said that in heaven he and she, they will not get married, because we will be free. The best thing you can get from God is your freedom. Freedom from what? From needs. Because we are at the end of the day living a slavery of needs. We need to sleep, we need to eat, we need to drink, we need money, we need to stay away from cold, because simply we are trying to survive. This is our needs, survive. And then when he says to you in heaven, you will not get married, he and she, you will be the same as angels, which means you will be out of needs, and then you will know a different level of happiness, which only people who live with God knows. Until that day, my beloved brothers and sisters, we say to you, thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you. Christ is Lord, and Islam is false. And we see you soon again. Take care and good night. Bye-bye.